So after over 5 hours of ride without the possibility to buy at least coffee, we showed up at Tbilisi station. In one piece. But to be fair, I need to mention that it's okay to smoke on the platform, so it was some kind of entertainment. Anyway, we wanted to take a taxi directly from the station, but the taxi guy, after staring at Google Maps for 10 minutes, still seemed to be a little bit lost. So God bless Bolt, for half price we reach our hotel. And it's again a hotel with bar on the roof and a stunning view, and it turned out that our room has a balcony. But the neighborhood was kind of confusing. On one side it was meant to be very close to the old town, on the other side, right after leaving hotel, we were struck by the view which resembles more the remote suburbs. But well, this is Georgia and such a contrast is quite common here. I really like my Prima 5, but I still can't figure it out. Sometimes it's sharp as a tack, and sometimes seemingly ordinary photo turn out like this. The lamp which should warn about long exposure wasn't blinking, so I don't know what went wrong here, but anticipating the fact this camera will ruin some more shots during the trip. Anyway, we are heading another cable car to see Mother of Georgian in all her glory. So the view is nice, Mother of Georgian still looks fine and pretty, the weather is hot and the beer is cold, it's time to hit the town. What can I say about Tbilisi? You can just immerse yourself in this place and spin in the streets and the knocks all day, trying to avoid people who want to pull you into some pointless attractions. We were lucky to be in Tbilisi just a day after Independence Day, so the streets were still decorated in such a cool way. And I'm not sure how long is the street, but those ribbons appeared to reach all the way to the horizon. Speaking of pointless attractions, there is another hill you can ride on, in this case with funicular. And again, there is a fun land on top and a Ferris wheel. You don't have to turn me on, we're going up. This time Ferris wheel didn't look as creepy as in Kutaisi, so there was at least slight chance that the last inspection was not in the 70s, but for example in late 90s. Anyway, this conviction turned to be enough to get us into the cab. If it wasn't for the fact that I realize I'm afraid of heights, the ride would be much more pleasant, but still it was quite okay. And I believe this wheel is the highest viewpoint in the city. And this TV tower looks so cool from there. Soviet Red Star and USSR emblem should not be surprising in the city where you can buy fridge magnets with Joseph Stalin. So the magic happened and we are now in Wake Park with this Soviet look monument. Well, it looks cool for me, probably not for you. But the whole thing is about film photography, and now it's time for His Majesty, Cinestill 800D. What's so special about it? 800T is an 800 ISO tungsten balance film, so it's really night photography beast. Well, of course, back in the days we've got even 3200 ISO films, but now 800 is all you can get. One more thing that makes the stack so special is that it's made with motion picture film, but with removed ramjet layer. Making long story short, that's why there is this cool red glow around lights, and that's why 800T can be developed in standard C41 process. So every lap will handle it. First shot, well, it's not a masterpiece. The strange red things are somehow connected with removed ramjet layer. and it's quite common that they appear on the first frames of this film. The graffiti tunnel is marked as an attraction on Google Maps with quite high rating. I was thinking, hey, every tunnel in Poland is covered with better or worse graffiti, so what's the big deal? But it turned out to be a really cool place. The strange construction is a fountain which is above the tunnel. We decided to take a walk from Wake Park to the Old Town. Afternoon is not perfect conditions for Cinestill, but still I took some shots. This number is fake, don't even bother yourself calling. Night had come, so this was the perfect time to check out the best of Cinestill. And just to be clear, even 800 ISO is not much without tripod. 1.4 lens is also not a game changer, so these are not portfolio shots. But I bought this film more out of curiosity than thinking about some brilliant pictures. So what can I say? I really love these colors. It's something you can't get while using, for example, Portra 800. And it's not impossible to find some spots where you can shot Cinestill without long exposures and shutter release cable. Just don't expect the same flexibility that you have in DSLRs with 6400 ISO or more. The next day we started with Chronicle of Georgia. It's some kind of monument consists of 16 pillars built on the hill near Tbilisi Sea, which is technically an artificial lake. Anyway, this Georgian Stonehenge records history of this country from its very beginning. And it's really breathtaking. Believe me, neither the film nor the photos reflect the majesty of this place. I've got with me Prima 5 with probably Kodak Gold, and the shots are more or less correct, but look what Cinestill does in a strong sunlight. Tungsten balance gives an 80s postcards vibe, and it looks so cool and unique like no other film stack. Next up was Fabrica. Fabrica is some kind of urban space created in the old sewing factory, because Fabrica means factory. It's a false friend. Anyway, it is located in quite interesting neighborhood, maintained in industrial style with hotel, diners, bars and some not ordinary places like graffiti store, board game club or record store. And there is also Magnolia Film Lab, which is I believe one of the few or maybe the only one place in Tbilisi where you can buy and develop film. And again, Cinestill performs quite well in here. But on my list of places to visit, I got two more that were still not checked off. And those places were in the middle of nowhere. I mean, still in the town, but out of tourist area. And there was no point in visiting them for more than 5 minutes, so I ordered a Bolt, added stop points in the app, and with all the Russian words I knew, I was trying to explain the driver what was the plan. It worked and we arrived at the former archaeology museum. And it's hard for me to tell you anything about this place. It was built in the late 80s, it was meant to be a place with all archaeological stuff found around the city. And today it's not working. That's all I was able to find about this building. I don't really know when it was closed and couldn't find any pictures from the times it was operating. It's a great example of Soviet modern architecture, so it's still worth a visit. And Cinestill again did a great job. This photo will suit some guidebook from the era. Here in the background you can see the Chronicle of Georgia, so I think now you can believe me how great it is. Next place was an iconic brutalist building, which is known as former Ministry of Highways building. But today it's Bank of Georgia headquarters. And I didn't think it out. Standing just in the front of this Tetris-alike building without wide lens was not so brilliant idea. So the shots are not even acceptable. The trip has ended near the giant bike, which is a well-known attraction in Tbilisi, but honestly, it's nothing special. So one last look at the Ferris wheel we were riding a day before, and it was time to get back to the hotel, because the next morning we had a train to Batumi. And this time it was new double-deck train, so I won't keep you in suspense. We got there. In one piece.